I'm your host, Greg Jamian, and you're watching Senior Matters. Today, we have with us Dave Crawford with Guardian Medical Monitoring, a subsidiary of Guardian Alarm, located here in southeastern Michigan. And Mr. Crawford runs the division that specializes in these new patient or senior monitoring devices that help keep seniors independent and in their own home, and that's the key. Welcome, David.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
David, you must be really busy these days with these with this new device. I call it the home alone medical monitoring device, because it allows seniors to be safe in their own homes. Tell us a little bit about Guardian Medical and what kind of products you sell and service.
You're right, we have been busy. The home alone alarm is great. I've heard it, a lot of people refer to it as I've fallen and can't get up buttons. It's a medical alarm or emergency response system. And Guardian Alarm Company started Guardian Medical Monitoring in 1999 as a division. And it's been our fastest growing division over the last several years with the aging population and the boomers, the baby boomers. So we provide technology that keeps people in their homes where they want to be, safely and independently. Guardian Alarm is the largest independently owned security company in the country.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. We have customers in Michigan, Ohio, Indiana, and Windsor, Ontario on the alarm side. And then our medical monitoring division is a nationwide company.
So, I mean, you're professionals already at monitoring, right?
We have highly trained people that are on staff 24/7. They really have to be trained not just to answer alarms, but to talk to seniors, talk to people that are in a precarious situation. So they're very caring. They love what they do. They handle a lot of actual alarms, and they stay on the phone line. They stay on that two-way speaker until someone comes in the home. So they're offering words of encouragement, and they're keeping the person calm so that panic doesn't set in.
Until EMS
gets there, or a family or a neighbor. That's an important point I'd like to make, is that this is the button here. When you push this and it sends a signal to the unit and comes to Guardian, we come on the two-way speaker and we assess what's going on in the home. Not always do you need an ambulance. Sometimes you want your next door neighbor to come over who agreed to be part of your support system, or your family lives two doors down and they'll come over. Milton Pierce, our founder and owner, is 93 years old. He still comes into work every day. He founded the company back in 1930, and we've been providing this monitoring service since. These life safety and property protection services, monitoring services, for that many years. We have a UL, which is Underwriters Laboratory listed monitoring center, factory mutual approved. Very few alarm companies have that. We have that so that we can monitor jewelry stores and furriers and banks and those types of establishments.
And now, mom and dad.
Typically, we have a lot of seniors who live alone who just want the ability to get help if they do have a fall. But we also have 40, 45-year-old women that live alone that are concerned about somebody breaking in or concerned that they may have a fall. So really there's a very wide range of demographics of who we have, but the majority of our clients are seniors that unfortunately a lot of times they've already had a fall and they know now that they need the button. We think that people can really benefit from it beforehand. But you tend to get a lot of people that say, oh, I'm never going to have a fall, I'm never going to have an emergency, and they're a little hesitant to order one. One out of every three seniors over the age of 65 will have a fall within the year. So most of the loss of independence is attributed to falls. And it's not just the fall, it's the complications that happen to seniors after they fall and lay on the floor for X number of hours. At the beginning of the discussion of bringing technology into the home, you get a lot of arm folding and no, I don't want that type of technology in my home. But you brought up, that or moving to an assisted type living or a nursing home or having somebody live in with you, and that really impedes your independence more than some kind of technology to help you stay there.
This is a medication dispenser. Can you tell us how this works and
This medication dispenser, actually a caregiver or family member would take their medications from their prescription bottles and fill them into these little cups. These cups are loaded into the machine. The machine will hold 60 of these cups, so you have 60 doses. If you're taking medications twice a day, you now have a month's worth or 30 days of medications in this machine. And there's a lock on the door here, so you can lock it and take it if you're worried about somebody getting in there. You can take the key. When it's time for the person to take their medications, they have scheduled times during the day, maybe at 9 o'clock and at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. The machine will give them a bright red blinking light, a text message will scroll across the screen, and then out of the speaker you'll get a verbal voice message that says it's time to take your medication, press the red button to dispense. And it'll continue to say that until the person walks over, pushes that button, and when they do, the dose will come down and sit in that compartment until they walk over and take it. Now, if they don't push that button after a certain amount of time, an hour, hour and a half of this thing blinking and talking, something's probably happened, but it gives them time to get out of the shower or get home from lunch or whatever the case may be. If they still haven't pushed that button at the end of that time, the machine will go into a missed dose mode. It'll put that dose into a compartment on the side here that a caregiver can get to later. And then the machine will call a caregiver and let them know that mom forgot to take her medications. Yeah. So at that point, the person can call, they can go over and find out what's going on. We like to say we have a continuum of care of technology. There's a continuum of care out there on many different levels, but ours is technology, and it starts with just an emergency response system. Goes to the medication, we have the pressure-sensitive floor mat, and if I could, I'd like for you to hear what would happen.
Oh, I'd like to hear that.
If maybe you have somebody upstairs and you'd like to know when they get up out of bed so you can go tend to them before they have a dizzy spell or anything like that, you could put this floor mat next to their bed and have this device downstairs. That's a wireless device. Have this device downstairs, and when they stepped on the floor mat, you would hear this.
Emergency call being placed.
So that's going to...
Alarm. Reset.
I just reset it with the cancel button so you can't have a false alarm. But that's going to do that for several minutes until you walk over and you hit that button.
I see.
And then you go and tend to the person and make sure that they're okay.
Now, would you put a rug over this? Or
you can. Typically, when we're going in to do an assessment in a senior's home, we're always telling them to get rid of the throw rug so they don't trip over them.
Sure.
But for aesthetics, yes, you could put that over a rug and
it
would still
work. But you could also put this in front of doorways, so if they were to leave the apartment or home in the middle of the night, it would sound the alarm, correct?
Or if you're concerned about them going down the basement stairs or something like that, you could put them anywhere throughout the house. And since it's wireless, you can move it around. As the baby boomers start aging, they're going to want more technology. And for them, it's not so cutting edge as it is for the 80 and 90 year old people from that generation. But the virtually their care, you can put a camera in a kitchen, maybe a bedroom, a living room. And at any given time during a day, a family member can log onto a computer and dial in and see that mom's doing okay. So now instead of leaving work and driving over there and worrying about, you know, how she's doing, they can now see visually. That's a look-in monitoring. We also have event-driven or episodal monitoring, where if someone were to step on a floor mat or open a door or push a button, that camera system could now call their computer, the family member's computer, and alert them. They could look over and see that mom or dad got out of bed and went to the restroom and came back and, you know, everything was fine, or maybe they fell out of bed, or maybe they walked out of a door that they shouldn't have, or any number of things. You can see all that, so you kind of become the monitor and you get to see what's going on.
Now, is that hard to hook up? Because if you were the remote person viewing in, would it be a hookup with Guardian, or would it be directly with a computer in the patient's home?
The beauty of it is that I don't have an exact answer for you, because it can be tailored to each individual's scenario. Everybody's got their own situation. So Guardian does monitor, yes. We do monitor some video. Sometimes family members just want to monitor that. Or ease of use, it's very simple. It's a software program that gets loaded. You've got an icon on your computer, you double click, and it makes a phone call, and there's your image. When we dispatch EMS, an ambulance because there's something going on in the home, there's an episode going on in the home, they're getting into that house. They're going to kick the door in. So we have on our profile of each individual customer a lockbox code, and we will tell EMS that there is a lockbox similar to what realtors use on the front door, and we'll tell them what the code is, and they can open that up, grab the key, and unlock the door.
Kind of like what the realtors have.
Exactly. This offers the caregivers the peace of mind knowing that while they're at work, mom or dad's at home, they're going to be able to get help. While they're at home sleeping, they're going to be able to get help if they need it. They're not going to lay on the floor for 3, 4, 5, 6 hours before somebody would come and knock on the door and find them laying on the floor for that amount of time. So, the caregivers, there's this sandwich generation out there of people that are taking care of mom and dad and they're taking care of their own kids and they're very, very busy.